press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Welcome to online classes. As far as the first PUC syllabus concerned, with regard to that, one of the important unit within the first PUC topic, that is one of the human physiology. Of course, one of the major and as well as important for board and as well as competitive exams. That is, the physiology is one of the branch of biology that deals with the study of the branch of biology that deals with the study of functions of internal body parts. Of course, the physiology is one of the branch of biology that deals with the study of the functions of the internal body parts, that is being called as the physiology. Of course, the physiology with reference to the humans, you may be already studied about the physiological process such as digestion, circulation, breathing and exchange of gases, as well as the topic excretory products and as well as their elimination. So it is one of the important for both board exam as well as the competitive exams. Okay, since the excretory products and their elimination, these excretory products may be some of the substances in most of the animals, some of the substances may accumulate within the body. Such substances, either it may be some of the substances may accumulate in the body of animals. The substances like, such as, it may be ammonia, one of the substance may accumulate in the body of animals, ammonia, as well as urea. Of course, uric acid, even carbon dioxide, and also some of the ions such as sodium, or it may be potassium, even it may be phosphates, even sulfates. These substances may accumulate in the body of animals. The accumulation of these substances, either it may be due to the metabolic activities. Metabolic activities. That means to say, the metabolism is the sum of all the total biochemical reactions that occurs inside the body of the living organism. So, due to the metabolic activities, some of the substances like ammonia, urea, uric acid, as well as carbon dioxide, and some of the ions may accumulate in the body. Either it may be due to metabolic activities, or it may be due to excess ingestion. So, for these two reasons, some of the substances may accumulate in the body of animals. Such substances within that living animal body, that the substances may be removed completely or it may be partially. So such substances are removed partially or it may be totally. The process of elimination of such waste, the process of elimination of such nitrogenous waste, the process of elimination of such nitrogenous waste in the body of animal, from the body of animal, the process is known as the excretion. So within this chapter you are going to study about the elimination of some of the nitrogenous waste that can accumulate in the body of animal that are being eliminated through the process called as excretion. So what is excretion? Definition is so simple. That means to say the process of elimination of nitrogenous waste from the body of animal. Usually such nitrogenous waste, they are present within the body of animal, particularly within the blood. So one question arises, okay, the process of elimination of nitrogenous waste from the body is known as excretion. Of course, the chapter that deals with the elimination of such nitrogenous waste from the body. So what are those nitrogenous waste? What are nitrogenous waste? Since the nitrogenous waste, they are the waste having a nitrogen, such as that is one of the nitrogenous waste called as ammonia. One of the nitrogenous waste called as ammonia, as well as urea, and also uric acid. They are the nitrogenous waste present within the body of animal. Such nitrogenous waste, they are being eliminated through one of the process called as the excretion. It is one of the special mechanism that involved to eliminate such nitrogenous waste from the body. Since that is the nitrogenous waste, such as either it may be ammonia, or it may be urea, or it may be uric acid. Since these nitrogenous waste, they are toxic in substances, they are toxic in nature. Since these toxic substances should be eliminated from the body. Yes. So out of these, ammonia, urea, or uric acid, out of these three nitrogenous waste, which is most toxic? You may arise one of the question. That is, out of these three nitrogenous waste, such as ammonia, urea, uric acid, which is most toxic? That is, out of these, most toxic is the ammonia. Ammonia is one of the most toxic substances. And for the elimination of ammonia, it requires lot of water. Since for the purpose of elimination of ammonia in the body of animal, that it requires lot of water to eliminate the ammonia, since it is highly toxic in nature. Similarly, out of these three, which is least toxic, which is least toxic? So least toxic nitrogenous waste, that is the uric acid. So the least toxic nitrogenous waste is the uric acid. You must note the point that as far as the competitive exams may ask, the most toxic nitrogenous waste, that is the ammonia. Least toxic nitrogenous waste, that is the uric acid. For the elimination of this uric acid, it requires less amount of water. So possibly the question may arise, in aquatic animals, in most of the aquatic animals, which is the nitrogenous waste that is been eliminated from aquatic animals? The answer is simple, that is ammonia. Because the ammonia that require lot of water to eliminate them. Similarly, the uric acid may be eliminated from the body of animals, especially in terrestrial animals. Because terrestrial animals, they are living within the land, so then facing some of the scarcity of water, in those animals the uric acid that requires less amount of water. So you must note that the most toxic nitrogenous waste is the ammonia, least toxic nitrogenous waste is the uric acid. Okay, next to this, let us go through with the depending upon the type of nitrogenous waste, that is eliminated by the animal, based on that, the animals of three distinct types. Depending on the type of nitrogenous waste eliminated by the animal, based on that, the animals were classified into three major types, such as one by one. One is the amnotelic animal. One is the amnotelic animal. Another one, ureotelic animal. Similarly, third one, uricotelic animal. So based on the type of nitrogenous waste eliminated by the animal, based on that, the animals of three types, one is the amnotelic, ureotelic, and as well as uricotelic. That is, the name itself indicates. The amniotelic animal. That name itself indicates that the animal which excretes the nitrogenous waste. The animal which excretes the nitrogenous waste, that is in the form of ammonia. So, the animal which excretes the nitrogenous waste, that is one of the ammonia from the body, such animal we call it as a amniotelic animal. The process of elimination of the ammonia, that process we call it as a amniotelism. Amniotelism. Since the animal which excretes only the ammonia, such animal we call it as an amniotelic animal. The process of elimination of the ammonia as nitrogenous waste, the process is known as amniotelism. What type of animals? The amniotelic animal, since the example for the amniotelic animals, that is, one is the aquatic amphibians. Aquatic amphibians, as well as the bony fishes, and also aquatic insects. They are the examples for amniotelic animals. That is, the ammonia is one of the nitrogenous waste that is eliminated from the body of the aquatic amphibians, as well as bony fishes and aquatic insects. I have already told that the ammonia is one of the highly toxic, more toxic nitrogenous waste. It require lot of water to eliminate the ammonia. So, preferably the animals, they excrete the ammonia, usually they are living in the water. They are having aquatic habitat. Since the examples, aquatic amphibians, as well as bony fishes, and also aquatic insects. How this ammonia will be eliminated from the body of these animals? Usually the ammonia which is been readily soluble in the water, since the ammonia readily soluble in the water through the process of diffusion. Such ammonia that is been eliminated through the body surfaces, or it may be gills surfaces, we have to observe, that is how the ammonia will be get eliminated from these animals. With regard to that, the ammonia will be readily soluble in the water. Such ammonia, that is through the diffusion, it is been eliminated, that is across the body surfaces or through the gill surfaces. Since you can able to observe, that is the kidney. What about the What about the functions of the kidney in these animals? Of course, these animals, aquatic amphibians as well as bony fishes, they are having kidneys. But the kidneys do not play vital role. Do not play vital role in the elimination of particularly the ammonia. So you have to notice this one. The ammonia is readily soluble in the water, and through the diffusion it is been removed to the outside. Either it may be through the body surfaces or it may be through the gill surfaces. Here the kidney plays passive role. That means to say, the kidneys do not involved in the elimination of ammonia. Okay, that too about the amniotic animals. What about the ureotelic animal? Okay, ureotelic animals, the name itself indicates, the animals which excretes the nitrogenous waste that is as urea. The animal which excretes the urea as the nitrogenous waste, such animal we call it as a ureotelic animals. The process of elimination of urea is known as ureotelism. The process of elimination of urea from the body of the animal, the process is known as ureotelism. Since the example for the ureotelic animal, one of the best example, that is ureotelic animals, that is most of the mammals, they excretes the urea, and also some of the marine fishes. They excrete particularly urea as the nitrogenous waste. So the mammals and as well as marine fishes, they excretes the urea as a nitrogenous waste. Since the animals we call it as a ureotelic animals, the process of elimination of urea is nothing but the ureotelism. Okay, such urea that is from these animals, mammals, either it may be marine fishes, such urea will be get eliminated. So how the urea will be get formed and it is been eliminated from these animals? Maybe question arises, the urea, how it is get formed and it is get eliminated? So that is, in these animals, that is the ureotelic animals, the ammonia is get formed through the metabolic activities. The ammonia get formed through metabolic activities. Such ammonia in these animals, it is converted into urea. That ammonia will be converted into urea, that is in particularly liver. So the liver is one of the important and the chief organ involved in the conversion of ammonia into urea. That formation of urea from the ammonia, that is been called as urea cycle, or it may be ornithine cycle. the process of conversion of ammonia into urea, that cycle we call it as a ornithine cycle, or it can be urea cycle. It is get synthesized in the liver cells, such urea, then it is been diffused into the blood. Such urea will be get diffused into the blood. From the blood, it is been filtered through the help of kidneys. So, that is how urea gets synthesized within the body of ureotelic animals. That is, the ammonia will be formed through metabolic activities, either it may be anabolism or it may be metabolism. Since the ammonia is get synthesized, such ammonia will be converted into urea. That is, through the ornithine cycle, that urea will be get synthesized only within the liver cell, and such urea diffused into the blood, and ultimately the blood will be filtered with the help of kidneys, so that urea will be eliminated through the urine. So how urea is get synthesized, and it is how it is been eliminated with regard to the ureotelic animals. Okay, then lastly, that is one of the uricotelic animals. The name itself indicates these are the animals, they excrete urico, that means uric acid. The animal which excretes the uric acid, such animal we call it as a uricotelic animals. So these animals, they excrete the uric acid, since they are known as uricotelic animal. The process of elimination of uric acid is known as uricotelism. The process of elimination of uric acid by the body of the animal, that process we call it as a uricotelism. That is, some of the examples for uricotelic animals. What are the examples can be listed with regard to the uricotelic animals? Best examples, that is, some of the animals which excretes the uric acid, such animals, uricotelic animal, one of the best example, that is the reptiles, as well as birds, and also land snakes. Since uricotelic animals, they excrete the uric acid, the best example, either it may be reptiles, birds, as well as land snails. These will excrete the uric acid as a nitrogenous waste, that is particularly in the form of such uric acid from these animals, which is been eliminated in the form of pellets, or it may be in the form of paste. So very important, as far as the nitrogenous waste, we have to remember the nitrogenous waste may be of three different kinds: ammonia, urea, and as well as uric acid. Whatever the animal, they excrete the ammonia, which is been called as amnotelic. The animal which excrete the urea, ureotelic. The animal which excrete the uric acid, uricotelic. And the process of elimination of ammonia, amnotelism. The process of elimination of urea, ureotelism. the process of elimination of uric acid, that is the uricotelism. We have to remember some highlight points, that is the ammonia. How the ammonia is get eliminated? Of course, the ammonia is readily soluble in the water. Through the process of diffusion, that been eliminated either through body surface or it may be gill surface. In case of amniotic animals, the kidney plays a passive role in excretion. While ureotelic animals, how the urea is get eliminated? Usually in these animals, through the metabolic activities, the ammonia will be get synthesized. Such ammonia will be converted into urea within the cells. You need to remember, the urea will be get synthesized within the liver cells. Such urea then diffused into the blood, and the blood finally it is been filtered by the help of kidneys, and through the urine the urea will be eliminated outside. While in case of uricotelic animals, that animals they excrete the uric acid in the form of pellets or it may be in the form of paste. Jothege nimge ee examples kuda nenpirli. So that amniotic animal, what are the examples? Ureotelic animals and also uricotelic animals. Maybe match the following, or it may be statement wise questions kuda kelabodu with regard to the based on nitrogenous waste. They are eliminated by the animal depending upon the nitrogenous waste. We can able to classify the animals of these types such as these. Okay, next content. Next thing within the excretory product and their elimination, that is excretion. With regard to that is particularly the survey is made on animals. Survey is made on animals to know about the excretory structures present within the animal body. That reveals that the animals, they represent different kind of excretory structures. Of course, you are observed that, you are knowing that the excretory structure or it may be excretory organs present in the animals, they are quite different. So the survey is made on the animals to observe, to notice the excretory structures. Such excretory structures may be different from one animal to another. So they represent different kind of excretory structure. For example, invertebrates. Consider invertebrates as well as vertebrates. Of course, invertebrates, they are the primitive group of animals. Then vertebrates, they are complex group of animals. Considering both of these, invertebrates, these animals, they are having excretory primitive primitive excretory structures. Primitive excretory structures, not so much advanced. They are having some of the primitive excretory structures. While in case of vertebrates, usually they are highly evolved and complex group of animals. These vertebrates, they are having the complex type of excretory organs. Excretory organs. What are those excretory organs? The two complex excretory organs within the vertebrates. That complex excretory organs are the kidneys. These are vertebrates, they are having highly complex excretory organs, they are the kidneys. While in case of invertebrates, of course, they are also involved in the elimination of waste, that is through some of the primitive excretory structures. Since the invertebrates as well as vertebrates both have the ability to eliminate the nitrogenous waste, that is by using some of the excretory structures or it may be organs. Only thing is that the vertebrates, they are highly evolved, so they possess complex excretory organs, that is the kidneys. While these invertebrates, they are having a primitive simple excretory structures. Then in detail with regard to the excretory structures, excretory structures of different group of animals as well as excretory structures different group of animals when we list. So that the excretory structures found in different group of animals, when you consider the animal, they are having all the animals, they do not have same type of excretory structure, they are having quite different. Since by considering this, while we list the animals, different group of animals having a different group of excretory structure, that is one by one let us come to the, that is some of the animals such as invertebrates, that is flatworms, that is the Platyelminthes. Flatworms, one of the best example, Planaria, or it may be tapeworm. These flatworms, they are having a excretory structure. Which type of excretory structure? Of course, you are studied with regard to the excretory structure in the first unit, Animal Kingdom. So these flatworms, they are having excretory structure that are the flame cells, or it may be called as protonephridia. Only the flame cells, not protonephridia. That is the flatworms, they are having excretory structure that are the flame cells. While some of the particularly the few annelids and also cephalochordates as well as annelids, they possess excretory structure that are the protonephridia. Protonephridia as the excretory structure in the annelids as well as cephalochordates. Similarly, some of the animals other than these. Consider the earthworms. Earthworms, that is, they are having the nephridia as the excretory structures. Nephridia as the excretory structure in the earthworm. They are also belong to the annelids. That means they are also the invertebrates. Similarly, another group of animal such as the arthropods, especially the cockroach, insects, these cockroach or insects, they are having the excretory structure. They are called as Malpighian tubules. Malpighian tubules. Of course, cockroach and insects, they are having the excretory structure. They are the Malpighian tubules. Similarly, within the arthropods, specific again, of course, in almost all of the arthropods, generally they are having Malpighian tubules. Within the arthropods, especially in case of crustaceans, crustaceans means, that is, some of the arthropods, they are being having some of the coverings, carapace. In those animals, the head and the thorax, they are being fused. That is a cephalothorax. Such animal arthropods in which the head and the thorax fused, they belongs to the crustaceans. One of the best example for crustacean, that is one of the prawn. Such crustaceans, they possess the excretory structures, that is antennal glands or green glands. They are the excretory structure. Since you must remember these excretory structures, they are quite different from animal to animal. The best, that is the animals such as flatworms, they are usually having flame cells. While the annelids, cephalochordates, they are having protonephridia. While the earthworms, they are also group of annelids, they are having nephridia. Cockroach and insects, they are the group of arthropods, they are having Malpighian tubules. While the crustaceans and the prawn, such as crustaceans like prawn, that is the antennal glands or green glands. Of course, it is very much important for competitive exams. What type of excretory structure being present within the kind of animal? The question may arise, what type of, particularly the excretory structure found in a particular type of animal? Or they may ask for match the following purpose or statement wise. Egadru kelle, you have to remember these, the animal as well as the excretory structures. Okay, next to this, that is okay, in the next session we are going to continue with the actual human excretory system in detail. Let us go through with the human excretory system. Okay, next class we will discuss on that. Thank you.